بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, خير القرون قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. That the best of times is my time, then the time after that, then the time after that. The first time was the period of Nubuwah, and there never could be anything better than it. The time which followed it was the second best thing. And that was the time of the Tabi'een, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam had passed away, and the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum were the ones carrying on the deen, teaching it in turn to the next generation that had not the good fortune of having seen Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And amongst that generation of Tabi'een, one of the greatest people was Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah. Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah's father's name was Yasar, and his mother's name was Khaira. His parents were both slaves that had converted to Islam. His father was the slave of Hadhrat Zayd ibn Thabit radiyallahu anhu, and his mother was the slave of Ummul Mu'mineen Hadhrat Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha. And so it was that in the 21st year after Hijrah, a child was born from this couple. And at this time, Khaira rahimahullah was working in the house of Hadhrat Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha. So Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah grew up in the house of Hadhrat Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha, which was the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So we can say that Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah actually grew up in the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was a Mubarak time, in a Mubarak place, around Mubarak people that Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah grew up. But there were two great factors which added to the virtue of Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah. The first was that while Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah was still a baby, he would be left in the care of Hadhrat Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha while his mother would go out for some work that needed to be done. And in those days, there was no powdered or bottled milk or anything of that sort. So while the mother of Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah would be out, Hadhrat Ummi Salama radiyallahu anha would breastfeed him. And it is through the barakah of this milk that the ulama used to say that Allah had granted him so much knowledge and so much wisdom. The second factor was that he was in the company of the greatest people after the Anbiya alayhimus salam. And the best person on the surface of the earth at that time made dua for him. Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah's mother would take him to the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum to make dua for him. And at that time, Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu was the Khalifa, Amirul Mu'mineen, and he was one of those that made dua for him. He made a dua saying, Allahumma faqqihu fi al-deen wa habibhu ila al-nas, that Allah, O Allah, grant him the understanding of the deen and make him beloved to the people. And this dua was accepted by Allah, because Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah was one of the most knowledgeable people that this ummah has ever produced. And he is someone that is loved by each and every single Muslim. There is not a Muslim in the history of Islam that ever had a problem with him up until this very day. Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah began his studies of the deen at a young age. And by the age of 10, he had memorized the entire Quran. By this time, Hadhrat Umar radiyallahu anhu had already passed away. And so Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah would always be present for the lectures given by Amir al-Mu'mineen Hadhrat Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu. The Sahaba radiyallahu anhum were the repositories of the knowledge of the deen. So there was no need to travel the world in search of knowledge, because where would you find more knowledge than by the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum? So Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah would listen to many ahadith directly from the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, and that is how he obtained his knowledge. That is why in the science of hadith, we have a clause which states that if Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah narrates a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam without mentioning who narrated it to him, then that will not affect the authenticity of the hadith, because he was of the utmost trustworthiness, and the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum are all above reproach. So if he didn't mention the name of the narrator, then it would not matter, because that narrator would have been a Sahabi or someone on his level. This same privilege isn't accorded to the Tabi'in who came later, because they may have had one or two people in their chain before reaching a Sahabi. Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah reached perfection in every field possible. He was a faqih. He was a wise person. He was a pious person. He was an eloquent speaker. He was a mujahid, amongst many other things. And when he would be described, the people would say he's the most knowledgeable of people. He was the most pious of people. After the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, of course, he was the most eloquent of people, and he was the bravest of people. إمام حسن البصري رحمه الله took part in the jihad with Hazrat Abdurrahman ibn Samurah رضي الله عنه against Kabul in Afghanistan as the Islamic Empire expanded. The ulama mention that when the jihad would be waged against the kuffar, then one of the brave knights leading from the front would be Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah. To speak of his knowledge, what more does a person have to say beyond the fact that the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum would direct people to him for questions on deen while they were still alive? Hazrat Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, a faqih from the fuqaha of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, someone came and asked him a question, and he replied by saying, "Go and ask our Mawla al-Hasan. Ask Mawlana al-Hasan." This is Hazrat Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, the khadim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a mountain of knowledge, the teacher of Imam Hassan al-Basri, and he refers to Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah as Mawlana. The son of Hazrat Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu used to say that I have not seen a person that was not a sahabi that resembled the sahaba radiyallahu anhum more than Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah. The teachings and wise sayings of Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah are still of the utmostly common used and referred to amongst the ulama and even the lay people. He was someone whose even seemingly small statements were great in meaning and equally great in value. Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah is one such person that no matter how much you seem to speak on his life, you can barely cover a fraction of it, nor can justice be done to explain just how great he was. On the day that Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah passed away, in the year 110 after Hijrah, such a crowd attended his janazah that on that one day, all of the masajid in Basra were empty for the Asr Salah because every single person was present for his janazah. May Allah instill within our hearts the love for the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, the Tabi'een, and the Atba'u Tabi'een, and guide us through them to follow the deen of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and not the modernistic religion which people peddle today that has no semblance to the Islam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, and the A'immah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen, wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.